The section of Plainfield that we are studying is the area surrounding the Netherwood train station. We looked at the possible development within and around the quarter and half mile radii. The Netherwood station still stands as a prime example of the prosperity and expansive boom that the Central Railroad of New Jersey experienced in the late 19th century. About 800 daily weekday riders currently board at Netherwood, an increase of more than 200% since 1995. The station recently underwent a $1.6 million renovation, which included improved parking, new lighting, a restoration of the station's platform, new landscaping, and a rebuilt tunnel connecting the north and south sides. South Avenue houses a series of small retail stores, as well as light industrial buildings. Directly west of the station is a historic Plainfield firehouse, which adds to the character of the area. The south side of the train station has greater pedestrian and vehicular activity as compared to the north. This suggests opportunities on both sides of the railroad tracks for expanded mixed-use development to capitalize on the presence of the train station. The area to the north of the station has relatively underutilized broad roadways with very low vehicular traffic. There are light industrial buildings immediately surrounding the Netherwood station. Some are still in use, while others lie vacant. Seidler Field is a large recreation field directly opposite the station's parking lot. Although well populated with only a few residential units empty, larger vacant industrial lots offer significant opportunities given their proximity to the train station. The Netherwood station has other assets that can support a TOD. These include schools, a nearby reviving downtown, recreational space, neighborhood suburbs such as Fanwood and Netherwood Heights, and good access from Route 22. A susceptibility to change diagram determines opportunities for redevelopment, including many lots immediately adjacent to the station, such as underutilized parking lots and large abandoned buildings. To gain a more comprehensive understanding of the area, we also mapped all the existing contaminated environmental sites. This led to our selecting of two main areas of opportunity. The first opportunity is the area immediately surrounding and including Netherwood train station. The second opportunity are underutilized lots along the east end of South Avenue. The first area of opportunity is the Netherwood train station, the parking lots that serve the station, and the adjacent properties. The area where the Netherwood station is located is currently zoned for light industrial and neighborhood commercial development. The station area does not take full advantage of traffic flowing to and from the station. The parking area of the station has a modest amount of unprogrammed green space. Two different atmospheres surround the station. The south has a single-level retail and pedestrian traffic. Directly next to the historic firehouse, there is underutilized paved surface. When viewing the north side, there are some light industrial spaces that are currently in use, as well as those that are underutilized. Through our findings, this area is marked as now susceptible to change. Brownfields are also present in the area, although the current extent of the contamination is unknown to us at this time. The opportunity in this area is for a lively urban square such as that found in Rahway, New Jersey, which has paved surfaces, trees, seating, and bike racks. Directly facing the urban plaza, there is great potential for ground floor retail access such as that found in Englewood, New Jersey. Certain portions of the plaza can house restaurant seating during the day and provide for a vibrant nightlife scene. The second area of opportunity is on the south side of the tracks to the east of the station that is highly auto-accessible. The existing sparsely spread commercial buildings on the site are surrounded with paved surfaces and parking lots. Through our findings, this area is marked as now susceptible to change. There is one contaminated site present in the area, although the current extent of that contamination is unknown to us at this time. Given the proximity to the Netherwood station in conjunction with the amount of auto-access retail, this site provides an opportunity for mixed-use development. A successful form of this development has occurred in the nearby town of Garwood, where new developments like the Muse at Garwood promote a strong pedestrian streetscape with parking in the rear. Also, Fells Point, Maryland, a 2-over-1 mixed-use area with angled parking in the front, is comparable. It has direct vehicular access, but still has a lively walkable storefront. We conclude today's look at Netherwood by mapping the proposed permeable surfaces, whether it's grass or soil. We found that the area immediately south of the railway embankment could be transformed into a combined pedestrian bike path and/or parking area for proposed development along South Avenue. This greenway can successfully tie together the areas of opportunity and create a truly walkable community around the Netherwood Station.